Hi, I'm Michael Audsley, and for this video I'm going to be reacting to the backstage interview with Paul Heyman from Raw, from Monday Night Raw.
Excuse me, Mr. Heyman. Can I get your reaction on what we saw earlier tonight between Brock Lesnar and Samoa Joe?
This is a follow-up. Follow-up from Samoa Joe and Brock Lesnar segment.
Are proud people. They're warriors. They're fighters. They're gladiators. They're trained from birth to take that fight straight to your face. Even the women in Samoa are trained to take that fight straight to your face. But oh no, not Samoa Joe. Oh no, Samoa Joe has been sneaked up from behind my client
Payment
and tried
again,
to apply
talking about.
Clutch. And don't get me wrong. In 13
Samoa
games,
Joe
Samoa
attacking
Joe
from behind.
Clutch on Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar has a problem on his hands. I will have an ex-champion on my hands. Against the wall, where he has to have it, so Samoa Joe can't jump him from behind. Now,
this whole thing has been about
be
Samoa Joe attacking Lesnar from behind.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen. This will be an all-night fight, a down and dirty and nasty and ugly and violent fight to the brutal finish. And what will happen? Brock Lesnar will finally take Samoa Joe to Suplex City. Brock Lesnar will finally hit an F5 on Samoa Joe. And after Samoa Joe is beaten, victimized, conquered, and emasculated by Brock Lesnar. Then, when they're waking up, Samoa Joe is smelling salts inside the trainer's room, and his alleged Samoan manhood has crawled up inside of his stomach. He's going to wake up and look at the trainer, and he's going to say, oh dear God, is that what it's like to fight the beast? Goodness gracious, great.
No, please don't say
fire.
That. Hate it when they say great balls of fire, but another good interview from Paul Heyman there. Thanks for watching this video, guys.